morning students, welcome back to my science online class. Today we will start a new chapter from your science book, which is chapter 9, the living organisms and their surroundings. Okay, so all of you open your books, page number 76. See the introduction. Introduction, point 1, our environment. Number 2, habitat. Number 3, types of habitat. Number 4, characteristics of living things. Okay, so in this chapter we are going to learn these topics. See, our environment. Living organisms live everywhere. In everywhere, living organisms are present. Okay, they live on mountains where it is very cold and are covered with snow. Living organisms are present also in mountain. Okay, they live on very cold climate or cold places which are covered with snow. Now see, they live in the desert where it is extremely hot and dry. So living organisms are also found in very hot places like desert, which are very hot and dry also. Okay, they even live on the seabed where it is completely dark. In the bottom of the sea, underwater, also living organisms are found. Can you think of a place or the earth where no living things live? So can you say that there is no living things any place? No, because everywhere living organisms are found. Okay, now see, the answer is no. You will find them even in the darker corner of your house. In your house, darker corner are present. So if you search for living organism in the darker corner too, you will find living organisms. Okay, now see, plants and animals living in different places and different from each other. Plants and animals are different and they are different from each other and present in different places. Our environment is our surrounding. What is our environment? Our surrounding is our environment, and our environment is our surrounding. It includes both living and non-living things. So in our surrounding, we can find both living and non-living things. Both types of things are present. Both types of organisms are present in our surrounding. Some are living things and some are non-living things. And living things cannot live alone. Living things cannot live alone. Remember this. They all need air to breathe. For the breathing, they need air. Food to eat, water to drink, and soil to survive. So the living things need air to breathe, water to drink, food to eat, and also soil to survive. Okay, thus a living organism is dependent on both living and non-living things and interact with each other. Living and non-living things both interact with each other. See, abiotic or non-living components of the environment include air, water, soil, sunlight, temperature, humidity, etc. In our surrounding, non-living things are present and they are also known as abiotic things. And these are air, water, soil, temperature, etc. Now see, biotic things or living things or living components. Living components include all plants, animals and microorganisms. Now see, ecology is the branch of science which studies the relationship between living things and their environment. Underline this sentence. Ecology is the branch of science which deals with the relationship between living things and their environment. How living things interact to their surrounding or interact to their environment. So the study of relationship between the living things and their environment is known as ecology. Okay, so students, it's your today's class. In our next class, we will discuss the rest topics of the chapter. Okay, so thank you. Have a nice day.